Howdy, folks. Live from Big Top Chautauqua, welcome to another episode of Tent Show Radio. Funding support for Tent Show Radio is provided by the Bayfield Inn. Stay, dine, and relax year-round on the shoreline of Lake Superior in downtown Bayfield. Any traveler, any season, any meal, your view awaits. More info at thebayfieldinn.com. And by the Bayfield Chamber of Commerce, beautiful Bayfield in the Apostle Islands. You can tour sea caves and shop our galleries and stores on the shores of Lake Superior. Info at lodging at bayfield.org. And by the Ashland Chamber of Commerce, the smelter running. Visit ashland.com to learn about outdoor fun and frolicking on Shawamigan Bay. And now, here's your host of Tent Show Radio, best-selling author, humorist, and singer-songwriter, Michael Perry.
Howdy, folks, and welcome to Tent Show Radio from Lake Superior, Big Top Chautauqua. Tonight, we feature a vintage, overflowing Big Top show from before the millennium, when none other than Merle Haggard parked his bus behind the big blue tent. And at intermission, I'll share a story about the outer limits of nostalgia. Folks, the music you're about to hear emanates from a special space in a special place. The Big Top is just that, a grand blue and pearl gray striped canvas beauty suitable for a circus, but in this case, home to a history of live performance centered on the stage. The Big Top seats are set directly on the earth, and what a spot of earth it is, high atop a hill overlooking beautiful Bayfield, Wisconsin, Lake Superior, and those all-natural, waterbound wonders, the Apostle Islands. If you enjoy that vision, if you enjoy what you hear over the course of the next hour, and if you want to see it and experience it firsthand, please get to know us at www.bigtop.org. It sounds beautiful up here because it is beautiful up here. You ought to come on up. One day back in 1999, a man from Bakersfield came to Bayfield with a bus full of strangers. That night, they set up on the Big Top stage and laid down the music you're about to hear. A list of hits made all the more impressive by the fact that it is but a partial representation of the man's work. He came out of the dusty parts of California at a young life of strife into country music superstardom without ever losing his common touch and easy virtuosity. Tonight, we go back to that evening and imagine ourselves happily crowded beneath the canvas as the stage lights come up, the band strolls out, and we welcome Merle Haggard.
Just remember that right or wrong, I'm still in love with you altogether. Thank you. Headed somewhere in flight, they're taking you away, leaving me lonely. Silver wings slowly fading out of sight. Tony B, I cried, don't take no airplane ride, but you locked me out of your mind and left me standing here behind. Silver wings shining in the sunlight, roaring engines headed somewhere in flight. They're taking you away, leaving me lonely. Silver wings slowly fading out of sight. Thank you. better be there long. The old man from the mountains is coming home. I've been working in a sawmill, I'm all up tight and tense. Got wind and someone's been digging under my back fence. Thought I'd better call y'all and let you know today. Old man from the mountains on his way. Yeah, the old man from the mountains coming home, home, home. But I better warn you so I call you on the phone. If it is to the grind, you better be there alone. The old man from the mountains coming home. Wind it up, son. Swim Kern River again. It was there that I met her. It was there that I lost my best friend. Now I live in the mountains. I drifted up here with the wind. I may drown in still water, but I'll never swim Kern River again. I grew up in an oil town, but my gusher never came in. The river was a boundary where my darling and I used to swim. One night in the moonlight, the swiftness swept her life away. Now I live on Lake Shasta, and Lake Shasta is where I will stay. There's the great San Joaquin, where the seeds of the Dust Bowl are found. There's a place called Mount Whitney, from where the mighty Kern River comes down. Well, now it's not deep nor wide, but it's a mean piece of water, my friend. Let me wait where it's shallow, but I'll never swim Kern River again. Oh, I'll never swim Kern River again. It was there that I met her. It was there I lost my best friend. Now I live in the mountains. I drifted up here with the wind. I may drown in still water, but I'll never swim Kern River again. I've got that old TB, I can't eat a bite. I've got that old TB, I can't eat a bite. Got me where it's so, I can't even sleep at night. I've got the TB. When it rained down sorrow, it rained all over me. When it rained down sorrow, it rained all over me. All my body rattles like a train out on that old SP. All together, boys. Graveyard is a lonesome place. God, that old graveyard is a lonesome place. They put you on your back, throw that mud down in your face.
Thank you very much. My name is Merle Haggard. These are all the strangers on stage. All the strangers on stage here with me. Nice to be here this evening. Such a lovely evening. Such a wonderful sound here in this little tent. I've always wanted a tent. Dreams come true, don't they? I'd like to take just a moment and introduce the strangers, if you don't mind. Would you guys introduce one another to each other? These boys have been known as strangers for some many, many years. They've been together since 1965. Some of them aren't that old. I'm the only original member still left. Wait a minute. Bonnie is an original yes. member. Boy, it's hard to believe it, that we were there when it happened, wasn't we? We were right there in the very beginning of everything. It wasn't anything before us, I don't think. But anyway, this is one of the honky-tonk bands in the world that have stayed together. There's not too many honky-tonks left. We started playing for drunks many years ago. And, We started playing for people that danced and, you know, and had a lot of booze and everything. They didn't really pay attention to what the music sounded like. And then they started to refine it and everything and started to put it into places like this where you could hear it. And then it was a whole new ball game. You know, it eliminated a lot of people like me right off the bat. Yeah, I do too, but I mean, it's ridiculous, you know what I mean? We don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee. We don't take no trips on LSD. We don't burn no draft cards down on Main Street. But we like living right and being free. We don't make no parties out of nothing. We like holding hands, bitching woo. We still let our hair grow long and shaggy, like the hippies out of San Francisco do. And I'm proud to be a Hokie from Muskogee, a place where even squares can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse, and white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. Football's still the roughest thing on campus. The kids there still respect the college team. Everybody, I'm proud to be a Hokie from the school, a place where even squares can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse, and white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all.
You are listening to Tent Show Radio.
Welcome to intermission, folks. The road to aging gracefully is filled with potholes, and many of those are filled with nostalgia. For instance, back a while ago one morning after chicken chores, as I leaned into the teeth of a deep freeze breeze and my fingers went numb in the time it took to walk from the coop to the porch, I beheld a warm vision of Jerry Sobel spinning the cap off an insulated water jug. I also had a vision of my mother asking why in tarnation I wasn't wearing my mittens, although, full disclosure, my mother never used such strong language as tarnation. Jerry was the farmer down the road, and the water jug traveled in the twine box of his John Deere hay baler, behind which I spent many summer afternoons stacking. In that moment, after pulling the pin on the loaded wagon and hitching up the empty, we'd set the cooler on the edge of the empty wagon, unspin the plastic top, and turn it over to catch the water from the miniature spigot, and then pass it around. I remember raising the water to my lips and seeing bits of chaff skating the surface tension of the water. Jerry would always swirl water in the cap after the last drink, then sling the water to the ground before screwing the cap back on. a little ceremony before we went back to work. Back in that deep freeze chicken coop moment of my freezing fingers, the visual memory of Jerry spinning the cap was accompanied by the sense memory of the sun, the sweat, the alfalfa leaves stuck to my forearms, and even the stillness of the shadowed stubble when the shuttle runner was late with the empty wagon as we lay beneath the shade of the full one, awaiting the sound of the approaching Johnny Popper. I thank goodness for memories such as these. They're mine as long as I can hold them, no matter what happens. They keep me grounded. They sustain my gratitude for the good life I was given. It's tempting to soak in them all day long as a means of easing the creaking bones of present realities. And there's where I tap the brakes. Yesterday, someone multi-forwarded me an email that was essentially a kids these days rant. It was mildly heartwarming until it veered off into under-examined, self-satisfied hoo-ha regarding the state of things now as opposed to them good old days when stoic souls ruled with firm and judicious hand, as long as you didn't check the closet or under the carpet, I editorialize. Today's kids are selfish and spoiled, the email read, as if today's adults were not widely in evidence. The thing is, there was much to be longed for in the rest of that email. The value of honest work and delayed gratification, the best simplicities of times past. I nodded my head more than once and have delivered similar sermons at my own dinner table. How I cherished the presence of seasoned elders like Jerry in my life. But the deeper I read into that email, the less I nodded. Today's kids rush to the store, buying everything they can with no concern for anyone but themselves. Well, that's a snappy line unless you've actually spent 10 minutes among the multitudes of young people who are studying, striving, volunteering, and living brightly. Never mind those who have nothing to spend at the store. I'm far too wishy-washy to make a good preacher. I'm convulsive in my caveats. I often retreat to the comforts of soft memory in the hard present. It is not mine to give lessons, but it is certainly mine to take them, even those drawn from the young, as they observe their elders and form memories of their own. And then there are those times when it is soothing indeed to settle into nostalgia without question or reservation, to let yourself float back in time to a pre-millennial warm summer's evening from a while back, when a man came to this tent and sang songs from a while back. Ladies and gentlemen, here's more Merle Haggard.
Dreams come true, don't they? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Can you send me luck from where you are? Can you make a rainbow shine up far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Can you really make a wish come true? Do you shine on just a chosen few? Is it over? Have I gone too far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Like two ships on the ocean, drifted apart. You found an island at sea. I'm still drifting with this pain in my heart. Won't you send her sweet love back to me? Twinkle, twinkle, like a star. You send me love where you are. Can you make a rainbow shine far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. waves on the ocean, we drifted apart. You found an island to see. I'm still drifting with this pain in my heart. Won't you send her sweet love back to me? Twinkle, twinkle like a star, and you send me love from where you are. Can you make a rainbow shine that far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. We're going to do one especially for all the folks that make a living on the highway. All of the musicians and highway patrolmen and all the prostitutes. Most of all, the truck drivers. And don't forget, U.S. Express hauls our stuff around. They take applications of truck drivers out there beside the fence. They'll take you with you right now. They'll put you to driving something in about 20 minutes. Go over and apply if you want to get out of town quick. You can take your wife with you if you want to. Or you can take your husband if you like.
There you go.
Ha, ha, ha. Or you can go by yourself and have a little fun. Me and my wife have fun together. I'd say, huh. All right, we're gonna do one called Ramblin' Fever. Go ahead. Just rambling fever in my soul.
been throwing horseshoes over my left shoulder. I've spent most all my life searching for that four-leaf clover. Yet you ran with me, chasing my rainbow. And honey, I love you too. That's the way love goes. That's the way love goes, babe. That's the music God made for all the world to sing. It's never old, it grows. Losing makes me sorry. You say, honey, now don't worry, I love you too. That's the way love goes. That's the music God made for all the world to sing. It's never old, it grows. Losing makes me sorry. You say, honey, now don't worry so much. I say, but I love you so much. That's the way.
One for all the working men called the Working Man Blues. Working man blues. Keep my nose on the grindstone, work hard every day. Get tired on the weekend. So I draw my pay, but I go back working. Come Monday morning, right back with the crew. Drink a little beer that evening and sing a little bit of these working man blues. Got to buy my kids a brand. said your hands are fit to use. Drank a little beer that evening, sang a little bit of these working man blues. This song goes out especially for all the working men. Oh, thank you very much. I live the kind of life most men only dream of. I make my living writing songs. And singing them. But I'm 41 years old and I ain't got no place to go. It's over. So I lie about my age and make the stage and try to kick footlights out again. I throw my old guitar across the stage and watch my bass man take the ball. The crowd goes nearly wild. See my guitar nearly fall. After 20 years of picking, still alive and kicking down some walls. Tonight we'll kick the footlights out, walk away without a curtain call. Tonight we'll kick the footlights out again. I'm trying to hide the mood we're in. Might not put on our rolling stomatic grin. We'll kick the footlights out again. Kick my rent. Most men only dream of. I make my living writing songs and screwing them up. But I'm 41 years old and I ain't got no place. When it's over, so I hide my age and make the stage, try to kick footlights out again.
Valentine.
Oh, yeah.
Won't you be my Valentine? And won't you share your space with mine? Be my Valentine. Summertime, we can run and play like summertime, with storybooks and nursery rhymes, and you can be my Valentine. Candy heart, if anyone could, you could have a candy heart. Well, you're the sweetest of all sweethearts. Won't you give your heart to me? Can't you see? I love you, Valentine. Won't you be my Valentine? Whoa! And won't you share your space with mine? And be my Valentine.
Funding support for Tent Show Radio is provided by the Bayfield Inn. With 21 hotel rooms, over 25 vacation rentals, a lounge, on-site restaurant, and rooftop bar, there's something for you at the Bayfield Inn. More info at thebayfieldinn.com. And we're brought to you by Bayfield County Tourism. Find out how to get in touch with your inner wild at travelbayfieldcounty.com. And by the Cable Chamber of Commerce. Cable, the gateway to Bayfield County, where world-class trails, forests, lakes, and adventure await. Visit cableforfun.com. That's cable, the number 4, FUN.com.
Merle Haggard, a legendary memory from a legendary tent. Well, folks, that's our show for tonight. Whether you beam it or stream it, we thank you for listening. We're as grateful as a guy who knows some young folks who are doing all right. We'd love it if you come on up Bayfield Way or down or over or through for a live show one day. Details always available at bigtop.org. You can visit me anytime at sneezingcow.com. Until next we share the air, remember, where I come from and here at Tent Show Radio, nobody ever says goodbye. They just say, well, I suppose.